If you're watching this video, you have most likely tried fasting or you're thinking about trying fasting and you're looking to make the most out of it. And so in this video, we're gonna break down three strategies that you can use to burn more fat while fasting. And before diving into it today, if you are looking for more ways to simplify the process of getting healthy and losing weight, make sure that you like this video, you tap that subscribe button, and you tap the bell to be notified when we release new videos. But with that being said, let's get into it. I remember back when I started working out and eating healthy, I had an adjustment period where for the first few years, I didn't really know much of what I was doing. I was learning a lot. I was doing a lot of trial and error. And because of that, the results that I was seeing with my body weren't as good as they could have been. And the same exact thing goes for fasting. If you are fasting and you don't know exactly how to do it and you're making mistakes and you're not optimizing your routines, optimizing the things you eat, optimizing the things we're going to talk about in this video, you're leaving a lot of your results on the table. And so let's dive into three strategies you can use to optimize your fat burning success with fasting. Now, number one is going to be paying attention to the quality of the foods that you're eating when you're not fasting. So obviously we know that we're gonna get better results if we eat higher quality foods all of the time. But when we're talking about fasting, specifically the meal that you break your fast with is going to be the most important to really optimize the benefits you get from your fast. And so what most people do when they fast for the first time or for the first few times is when they break their fast, they'll kind of eat whatever. But when you're coming off of a fast, your body is as delicate as it will ever be. And so the nutrients you're feeding yourself and the quality of the micro and the macronutrients is gonna be massively important for the results that you see. And so when you're coming off of your fast, it's always a good idea to start with very high quality vegetables, move into proteins and fats, and then ultimately after your body has started digesting the food and working through it, then you can move on to those carbs. So ultimately what happens when you're in a fast is your body is in a very fragile state. And if you're to have something such as a starchy carb, what's going to happen is it's going to spike your insulin in your body and your body's reaction is going to be to store food as fat. And so my biggest tip is make sure when you're breaking your fast that you know how you're going to break it and that you follow through by eating very high quality foods and limiting things such as carbs and dairy. Now, number two is gonna be as simple as fasting for a longer period of time. Meaning, rather than doing a 12-hour fast every single day, maybe bump it up to 13 hours, and then 14 hours, and then 15 hours. And so it sounds simple, but as soon as you break your fast, your body switches over and it starts using a completely different form of energy. Your hormones change, and a lot of other things going on in your body change. And so to fully reap the benefits of your fast, it's a very, very good idea to stay in that fast as long as possible. Now, I'm not saying go out and fast for 23 hours every single day, but what I am saying is if there's room to increase your fast, even if it's by 30 minutes, over time that's going to compound and give you more results with your weight loss. So number three is going to be doing a workout while you're in your fasted state. Now there's been a little bit of controversy with this point. A lot of people believe that when it comes to fasting and working out, that it's not a good idea because it causes you to pull from muscle storage and not burn fat. But in the most popularly cited study, participants were actually given a meal replacement shake to break their fast right after their workout. And the replacement shake was full of sugar. So it spiked that blood sugar and it caused their body to store fat. And so doing a fasted workout is a very strategic way to make sure your body is burning more calories. Now, you can focus more on cardio when you're doing a fasted workout, but it's also a good idea to do heavy weight training while you're fasting. So when the body needs energy, its first source of fuel is gonna be something called glycogen, which is stored in your muscles. And when you work out, your body's gonna pull that glycogen from your body. Now, basically, you're gonna run through that glycogen, and then when you have no more left, your body's gonna start burning fat. So by lifting heavy weights, you're actually pushing out that glycogen faster, which is gonna allow your body to switch over to fat burning mode even faster. So the next time you're fasting, even if it's just intermittent fasting for 12 hours, if you can hit a workout during that 11th hour, you could be in a better position to burn more fat while you're fasting. And those are the three strategies. Very simple, very sweet, but if done, they can be very, very effective. And so my question for you, and I would love for you to leave this in the comments, is how often are you fasting? And what can you use from this video to implement a better fast, to get more results from your fast? Leave me a comment and let me know. But before we go, I wanted to include one more bonus into this video, and that bonus is going to be consistency, right? The only way you're gonna see incredible sustained results from your fasting is if you stay consistent. And this could be done by doing a 12-hour or 16-hour or an 18-hour fast every single day. Or you could break this down and do something like I do, which is do 24 hours every single week, and it's only once a week. But the point is that in this process, process, you're committing to something, you're staying consistent to build that consistency muscle, and in the process, you're gonna reap more of the benefits from fasting. Now, before we go, if you are currently fasting and you're struggling to stay consistent or you're struggling on your weight loss journey, make sure you go down below this video and check out the link for our free course. In this course, we're not only gonna simplify the process of weight loss and getting healthy, but we're gonna do so by breaking a lot of common myths that people are falling into and mistakes that they're making with their fitness, and also by laying out a very, very simple strategy for making small shifts that are gonna make a huge difference with your health and your fitness. The truth is that a lot of health plans out there have you running into a brick wall, hoping you're gonna break through. And so what we teach in this course is all about taking that sledgehammer and just completely breaking through that wall and running through it. And so check that out. And of course, make sure you like this video, subscribe to the channel, hit the bell. Also check some videos to the left of me to see what else we got going on the channel. But I appreciate you a ton. And as always, remember, eat smart, sleep deep, move more, and be grateful for this moment. I'll see you in the next video.